All right, welcome back to Currency 365. It is June 12, 2018. Hope you guys are doing well. Hit the subscribe button if you're new. Welcome aboard the 365 crew. Man, Kim Jong-un and Donald Trump yesterday actually met. Kind of interesting. I'm going to talk about it on my backup channel, Eyes Open Media, later today. So we'll talk about that. But I did post a news BTC video here. And so check it out, the cryptocurrency events video from with Jessica. So check that out. And also, let's get into the the big topic here, which is Coinbase. Coinbase announced yesterday while everybody was sleeping that they are adding Ethereum Classic, okay, to Coinbase. Okay, so they're going to start the last phase of adding Ethereum Classic to Coinbase. So you're going to be able to see when you go to coinbase.com, you're going to be able to see Ethereum Classic. Okay, so I for me personally, I thought this is way overdue. I thought we were going to see Ethereum Classic, last year, you know what I mean, with Litecoin. I mean, it should have been added back then, but it wasn't. So they're adding it this year. So this is going to be the new, they're adding this one. Okay, so last year was Litecoin. On this year's Ethereum Classic. And good, because, we've been calling buy signals on Ethereum Classic since it was, what, $3? So, you know what I mean? So it's good to see it. Okay, so I'm thinking yesterday was around $12. It spiked to about 16 something and then came back down to about 14, 15 bucks. So it doesn't really matter. I think it was at $40 sometime this year. So it exploded sometime this year to $40. We had a subscriber say, hey, something big is coming for Ethereum Classic about a week or two ago. And I told you guys about that. I even told you guys to start loading Ethereum Classic under the 50-day moving average. When it's underneath there, that's the loading zone. And I even said the other day, this is a great time to load Ethereum Classic. Okay. So even if it falls, I'm going to continue to load. It's going to be on Coinbase. And we know what happens when coins get on Coinbase. Okay, so I'm going to continue to load Ethereum Classic. I'm going to try to buy some every week now until it's added. I think they said in a couple of months it will be added. They're going to give us the actual date of adding. So I'm going to be adding to my Ethereum Classic before it joins Coinbase, because a lot of people are not going to buy Ethereum Classic until it's on Coinbase. Many people on Coinbase don't have other exchanges. So this is why you see the big explosions when things come on the Coinbase, like Litecoin did, or when Bitcoin Cash came on the Coinbase. It exploded because a lot of people, especially the newbies, they don't have Binance and Bittrex and these other exchanges. They only have Coinbase, and they only know how to work Coinbase, right? Because it's easy to use. So what's going to happen is you got about a million to maybe 5 million people that are going to wait to, maybe bring some money into Coinbase and put it in a USD wallet, and they're going to wait for Ethereum Classic to be added, and they're going to buy the crap out of it. And by that time, it'll probably be around maybe 30 to 50 bucks, okay? And they'll buy the crap out of it, maybe shoot it up to about $300, okay? Because they don't know how to use the exchanges, so they only have Coinbase. Okay, so I'm going to be buying Ethereum Classic. I don't care if it goes down to $10, okay, or $9. I'm going to be buying the crap out of Ethereum Classic every week until it's added. And then once it's added, we're going to see about a million people load up on it on Coinbase, because that's all they use, okay? And it should run into that date anyways, right? It should run into that the date is added anyways. If they do announce a date, it should run up into that date, and then the people on Coinbase that only use Coinbase will then be able to then load it up even more if they want to, or they could wait for it to come down a little. But usually when something's added on Coinbase, it's up like 100% in like a second. Okay, and also Binance adds Ethereum Classic, Binance to, and also Ethereum Classic USDT. Okay, pairing. So they made that announcement as well. They try to, spoil Coinbase announcement. Like Coinbase made that big announcement. Like, okay, let's make our ETN announcement as well. I mean, ETC announcement as well. So they did that as well. So ETC, BNB. I can't wait for ETN, right? Electronium should be. Where is, they already have their application in for Binance. I can't wait for Electronium to be on Binance. I want to see that thing explode to 10 cents, 20 cents, 30 cents, whatever it's going to explode to. But anyways, yep, that's what it is. And let's get to the charts here. Well, actually, let's look at the top 200 by Bitcoin dominance 39%, 14 billion in volume. That's very low. 294. Okay, we were just at 300 when I went to bed. Now we've lost 6 billion in the market. Okay, so that tells me that if that is true, we did not see the bottom. The bottom's not in. The bottom is not in. Okay, so that tells me the bottom is not in. Okay, and you can see on the charts the bottom is not in. Okay, so we're gonna go a little bit lower, not that much lower, but a little bit lower. We probably go, I don't know, 6,500, 6,400, 6,300, 6,200 maybe before the final bottom is in. Okay, so that tells us that we did not see the spinning tops, that the spinning bottoms that I was looking for last night. They actually went bullish. Okay, so here's Ethereum Classic coming down a little bit now, relaxing after a nice pump. Okay, and it wasn't really that big of a pump. It went from $12 to $16. So people are like, oh my God, it's a big pump. That's nothing. $12 to $16, and it was at $40 a couple of weeks ago. Like, come on, that's nothing. So, and the markets are just so bad right now. So it's going to be really good for those that are buying Ethereum Classic overall in the long term, knowing that it's going to be added to Coinbase. So if you bought some last night around 15, 16 bucks, don't worry about it. Just continue. In my opinion, I'm going to continue to buy Ethereum Classic as we get closer and closer to the date of adding to Coinbase. Imagine if you had done that with Litecoin when Litecoin, Charlie Lee said, hey, Coinbase, let's add Litecoin to Coinbase. And Coinbase said, cool, let's do it. And they were at $2. And then they started to climb and climb and climb and climb. And then I came out with a buy, and I called the buy signal at $8 for Litecoin. And then it continued to climb, went to 15. Coinbase adds it. I think it was at $17. Coinbase adds it. It went right to 25. Okay, then it went to 32. And then it went to all the way to 430. So, I mean, you could have retired on that, right? If you had gotten it at $2. If you had taken that tweet from Charlie Lee to Coinbase seriously, you could have been retired right now. You could be a multi millionaire right now, right? And so we need to take these things seriously, man. And so right now, people aren't taking Ethereum Classic seriously, when Coinbase announcement was for Litecoin was announced. No one really cared. Only the really, really people were buying Litecoin at $2-$3. Other people didn't care. They were like, oh, whatever. And then when the price started to shoot up, people were like, oh, man, Litecoin's going to be added to Coinbase, you know? And then they finally took it seriously. Zencash, okay, up 9%. Still under 20 bucks, though. Wow. Let's see here. I don't even know what the coin of the... I guess it's Ethereum Classic. Okay, so Ethereum Classic is a coin of the top 200. Yeah. Okay, so here's the rest of the coins. So we'll put Ethereum Classic on the thumbnail cover. Okay, let's see here. Wow, I hate these black boxes, man. Somebody said it's some type of virus or something. I don't know. Pillar back down to 17 cents. Wow. That's just crazy. I can't wait till their wallet is released and their conference comes. I think that's going to give them a lot of momentum at that point. But that's July 15th to July 22nd. So people are going to wait off. Maybe they'll start buying around July 1st and then 2 weeks into the before the launch. So I'm not worried about this. We're going to see another pump when we get about 2 weeks out. I even said it back then, when we get 2 weeks out, I think we're going to see Pillar go, right? We're going to see Pillar make a move back to a dollar or something. So just wait it. Got to wait it out. Okay. Now, hopefully there's no delays in their wallet either. Hopefully the wallet does come out around July 15th to 22nd during their, I think that's when their conference is as well. I believe, I'm not sure, but hopefully that brings a lot of momentum and people, and we see, you know, I just want, you know, give me $3. Give me $3 Pillar and I'm happy, man. I'll be happy, man. This market is so bad. I'll be happy with $3 Pillar. And I wouldn't even sell all of it. I'll sell maybe like 80% and hold 20 for the rest of the, in my private keys for years to come and see what happens. See if it can goes even to maybe it's $1,000 one day, you know, maybe it's, and so you just never know. You don't want to sell everything so early. You know, imagine selling everything 80% at $3 and then in a year or two later, Pillar's at $600. You're like, what the freak? I sold 80% at $3. You know what I mean? That would suck, you know, but hey, it is what it is. People did that with Bitcoin too. But at least if you hold 20% of it, it won't be that bad. Okay, so here's Bitcoin going down. We're now, and like I told you guys, we were going to see if these lines were down here, and we're not. We're only, the blue's only down here. That means we still have another leg down. And we also didn't get a spinning top. So that spinning bottom, as I call it, did not happen. Look at that. So that tells us we have another leg down. Because if we had gotten a spinning bottom, that would have been the end of the downward trend. So it's not. So it looks like we're going to go down one more time. And then hopefully we get a spinning, and we actually get a spinning bottom. And we actually get into extreme oversold. Okay, so that's what's coming for Bitcoin. It is what it is. So, and people's, on some people's charts on Bitcoin, looks like the apex isn't until like mid-July. So some people's charts on Bitcoin USD, the apex is until July, like mid-July, like mid to end July. Like, that's crazy. So, okay, so that's what some people's charts look like. And then others, Litecoin's chart has the apex coming up real quick. So it's kind of weird. I don't know how this is going to play out. You know what I mean? But it's kind of weird because Litecoin, and so we're done with Bitcoin here. Bitcoin is the bears are in full control, and we're going to get another leg down. So we're probably going to see 65, 64, 63, 6200 Bitcoin here, and then that will complete this transaction. So if you want to, if you're going to do a wave pattern going down, this would have been the start of one. So one, two, three. This one is three. This leg down, and then four back up here because we didn't get the spinning top. So that'll be four, and now we're waiting on wave five is coming. So that takes us about 6200, 6400 range, and then we'll be done. And then we'll do a zigzag up ABC upwards, you know, ABC, and then we'll probably go sideways, and then we'll probably explode upwards. Okay, especially if Litecoin breaks out, right? So if Litecoin comes to the apex and breaks out, so let's say if Litecoin has another leg down, as we're going right now, so the last leg down for Litecoin will probably be 102, 101, 100, right? And so then we'll get an ABC correction, and then Litecoin is going to be right on the apex, I think. You know, we're really, really close to Litecoin's apex. I think it was like June 18th on the USD charts. You guys got to look at your charts. But it's like somewhere around here. So we go one more leg down, we get an ABC correction, and then we probably explode out of this triangle for Litecoin. Bitcoin would also be doing its ABC correction, and then maybe also tries to explode upwards as well. Yeah, this is going to be interesting to see how this plays out. But yeah, this is the last leg down. So that's going to be a good sign for Bitcoin. Last leg down, ABC correction, go sideways, maybe then start to explode upwards. So since we're in this channel, and Litecoin should be rallying as well. So yeah, this is going to be interesting to see how this plays out. But one more leg down, guys, and it's not going to be that long. It's going to be maybe $200 to $300, $400 downwards, and then that's it. So that's good news. And then we'll rally for a couple of weeks or a couple of months, you know. Bitcoin Cash, okay, bulls buying the dip, trying to stop it from going lower, you know. And we did actually get it. We did actually on Bitcoin Cash get a spinning bottom here. I mean, a spinning bottom. So we did get the spinning bottom, but we are going a little bit lower. But maybe we stop here. Maybe this is it for Bitcoin Cash, a lot stronger than Litecoin and Bitcoin. So we might be stopping here. We might not go a little bit lower. But hey, look, if Bitcoin pushes it to 6,300, then Bitcoin Cash is going lower. Okay? we're not gonna stay up here when Bitcoin is going lower. No, we're going to go lower with Bitcoin. But we're a lot stronger. Same thing with Ethereum. We're a lot stronger than Litecoin and Bitcoin right now. So even if Bitcoin did go lower, we would probably stop here at five. I don't even think we're going to break 500, so that's pretty good. Okay, so that will give us a nice little double bottom here, right? Okay, and the lines will finally be in the oversold as well, and then we can start making our ABC correction and our and then go sideways and then start to climb back up. Vertcoin. Oh yeah, put your comments. Put your coins. I said put your comments. Put your coins in the comment section, and I'll be looking at them tonight. I did see some of you guys ones from yesterday's video, so I'll be looking at all that tonight. Vertcoin. Okay, going sideways here. Boost in control of the candle, not the wick, and we are neutral right now. Trying to hold off of a sell signal there and oversold, but just going neutral right now. The markets are, you know. I think we need to just stay right here because the markets aren't dealt for a big run right now because Bitcoin's about to finish its fifth leg down. And then we can start to, you know, see a correction from there. ADEX trying to make a move now after I talk bad about it. So every time I talk bad about something, you know, there, you know, it starts to make a move. Buy signals in for ADEX. Somebody said talk bad about bread. Yeah, I know. Well, isn't that crazy? Every time I talk bad about something, it starts to move. That's crazy. But I have to do it genuinely. I have to do it without knowing, without pre-planning it. It just has to be normal. It's just, I can't just talk bad about something and expect it to move. It has to be like a genuine thing. Okay, so bread had a double bottom here. So and we have a nice doji here. And so... good. You know, the bears are in control of it right now, but we did buy all the dips on the wick there. So nice little bottom, double bottom here. So, you know, wait out. And this is my thing. Wait out Bitcoin's fifth leg. As soon as Bitcoin's fifth leg is completed, I would grab some bread if you guys want to grab some bread. Matter of fact, that's when I will grab all the coins, right? When Bitcoin finishes its fifth leg down, which is going to be around that $6,200 to $6,500 range. Once you see that thing finish, it's going to do an ABC correction, right? And so that's when that fifth leg is completed, that's when you want to be buying your altcoins, right? Because Bitcoin then is going to do an ABC correction. And it's not going to be an ABC correction downwards because we're going down. It's going to be an ABC correction upwards, right? So it's going to be the opposite of what we usually see. Okay, so... We're going down now on Omiso Go. So hopefully we hold this line here, but if we don't, then we will come back here and touch this 50-day moving average. It will still be a higher low than this line here. Okay, so you got your low, you got your shooting star, you know, which was a bear signal, and then we have our high, and then we're gonna have our higher low right on the 200. We should be able to hold that 200 because Bitcoin is only going to go down about another $200 to $300. So we should be able to hold this 200, and that would give us our low, high, higher, low pattern on Omiso Go. And this is where you would be buying, right? And then wait for a buy signal to come in, a MACD cross. Okay, let's see. Anything else? Let me look at the ones that are in the green. I don't like red ones. ARC. Okay, bulls in control of the candle, not the wick, though. Coming into oversold. So wait for this to come in to extreme oversold, and then you might want to start picking up some there. I think you just got to wait it out. And sometimes you get tricked out, you know what I mean? So just wait it out. Wait for extreme oversold, then maybe you start to grab some. Dash, another big wick down. Bulls bought the dip. Buy signal came in on that. Bulls in full control of the candle, doji, whatever you want to call it. And yeah, okay. Doesn't mean anything until we get out of this zone. I mean, we've been in here forever. We need to get out of this. We need to break this 50-day moving average and come up here and actually show some life. Like, this coin looks like it's dead, right? So... I don't know what happened to Dash. Like, they haven't put out any news. Like, they're not doing... Like, I remember when Dash was putting out news, like, every 3 months. Like, and people on Facebook, like, YouTubers were talking about, oh, something new from Dash came out, right? Now, this looks like a pump, right? But on the reality, it's only up, like, $3. You know what I mean? It only went from, like, $12 to 15, to 16 bucks. So, but, you know, on the charts, it looks like a massive pump, right? So that's deceiving. So, but it's still, you know, it's the chart. So the chart we hit right here, We actually went right through that 200 and then we came all the way back. So hopefully what I want to see is I want to see as Bitcoin finishes its fifth leg, I want to see us maybe drop back to this 50-day moving average, hold that 50-day moving average, which will be a good bullish sign. Hold that 50-day moving average as Bitcoin finishes its fifth leg, and then ABC correction on Bitcoin, we go up and we break this 50-day moving average, and we continue to go as Bitcoin stabilizes, right? Coming out of the five-wave pattern down. Okay, so that would be a good sign. We have a lot of room to work here on Ethereum Classic. So, I mean, we were up here with no Coinbase news, right? We're right here. So we can run a lot, okay? So knowing that it's going to be added to Coinbase in the coming months or in the next 2 months or 1 month, whatever it's going to be. It could be 6 weeks, could be 8 weeks, could be, I don't know, could be 7 weeks before it's added. So I think when Litecoin got the news they were going to be added, I think it took 2 months. So yeah, something like that. So anyways, okay, Cash. Nothing's going on there. Not, you know, you can't really make money on stuff like this. There's not a lot of movement going on. It's coming into oversold as well, so we'll wait for it to drop in there first and then see what happens from there. But bulls are in control of the candle though. And then you got DNT. Okay, nice downward trend here, trying to break it with a buy signal, a weak buy signal, so not a lot of movement right now for DNT. We might even go lower. Veritasium, okay, just sitting there. Got a doji on it, still has a buy signal on it. Got a doji, bull break still at the 50-day moving average. Nothing has changed. Dogecoin, whatever you want to call it. Buy signal's trying to come in, and we can break this for 200 moving day. We will get that MACD cross buy signal, and we can make a nice little run here, break this 50-day, and come back up here. Okay, so doggy coin trying to make a move. It's got to break that 200 moving day though. Komodo, it seems like the same ones are green every time on this chart. Like we're looking at the same ones. Komodo, okay, bulls are in control of the candle there, and cool. Let's see here, trying to hold on. So we have, hopefully this is a nice little bottom here. And we start to go like, maybe we go like this and then start going up, you know what I mean? Start another wave pattern, but we have to wait for Bitcoin to complete its five-wave pattern because I think that's going to have an effect on everything. When Bitcoin drops another $200-$300, that will affect a lot of coins, right? Somebody said they wanted to look at ontology, right? It's okay, so we could probably come and touch this 50-day moving average if Bitcoin drops another $200-$300. We'll probably touch this 50-day moving average, and then we'll probably hold there, and then that's when people are going to be buying. Might even go a little bit underneath it. People will be buying the crap out of there, and then take it back up. Maybe a nice little V-shape back up. And last one would be is this one right here, Zencash. Actually, let me look at Zcash as well. Come up to Zcash. Okay, so Zencash bears in control of the candle, but bulls in control of the wick right now, though. Okay, so we got a nice little doji there. Buy signal still in for Zencash. Bottom was 17. So let's see if that bottom holds and we start to make our move back up when Bitcoin does its ABC correction upwards. Same thing for Zcash. Looks like the bottom could have been in right here at 192, 191. So let's see if we go sideways and then start to make our way back up. Okay, so that's it. You know what I mean? Wait for Bitcoin's last five wave down, which is happening now. Looks like it's about to happen now. I think it's happening right now because it's starting to come down. The bears are taking control. So the fifth wave for Bitcoin is coming down. Wait for it to complete, and then that's when I would be grabbing some altcoins because then Bitcoin's going to do a ABC correction upwards, and then it's going to probably go sideways. And usually when Bitcoin goes sideways, the altcoins start to make their run, okay? And then maybe we'll see a five-way pattern upwards if Litecoin breaks out of the apex, if it is truly at the end of its apex on its USD side. Okay, so let's see how this all plays out. It's going to be interesting to see, but like I told you guys, I'm buying Ethereum Classic. If it goes down more, I'm buying. If it goes up, I'm buying. I don't care. I'm buying. I'm buying. I'm buying. until it's added on Coinbase. Okay, so they said they were gonna make the announcement of when it would be added. I don't even care. I mean, don't even make the announcement. Just add it out the blue. I mean, that's even better for me. But I think they well, the Bitcoin Cash, they did tell us the date. So and people started running the crap out of it upwards, right? So they told us it was gonna be end of the year, early the first 2 weeks of January. So and people and then that thing started to run like crazy, and then boom, there it happened, right? So it should happen. Hopefully it's the same thing for Ethereum Classic. They'll give us maybe not a certain date, but a time frame, like maybe the first week in July, the first week in August, you know what I mean, something like that. And people will just buy until it's added. So anyways, that's what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna try to grab some every week until it's added on Coinbase. Peace out, God bless, take care, like, subscribe, and share, and upvote me on Steemit if you have Steem power. Peace out.